48 coins for that one. This imp is a total bro. Fucking lifeguard. It'd be great if they had a beach ball back here that you could, like, bap around or something. This is so fucking stupid. Yo, dog. He's a hunk imp. Get it right. Too cool for an Earth invasion. He plays volleyball and trains. He also owns a shop. Alright. Fucking Christ. Just gonna max out the guns that matter here. Alright, and we still have like 600 fucking rounds left. Jesus Christ. Or 600 coins left. 700 coins. Alright. That is totally a fucking shelter. I don't like it. Enough time if he starts. That's how you know if somebody does CrossFit. Isn't it? Like, that's the meme. That you know if somebody does CrossFit. Don't worry, they'll tell you. It's like vegans. Alright. Spooky sunken ship. Alright, guys, it's time for the horror episode here. And by horror, it means they've just dropped the gamma to zero and- Oh! Fuck! I'm officially spooked. Oh shit, reload! God damn it. The only weakness of the double-barreled shotgun. I just need this thing to be drum-fed and all will be well. Yeah, it's spooky cell. Look at, like, we got green glow and kelp. The only thing that could make it more terrifying are veg- Oh, I forgot about these things. The fucking lost souls that- These things are such a pain in the ass.
Cheese for everyone!
Oh, Sheogorath. I'd stream Oblivion or something, but I think people would get mad because I'd just, like, focus purely on the main quest and we'd be done in, like, 2 weeks. The fuck is that? It's a zombie fish! Jesus. Right in my hit points. Shivering Isles was such a fucking good expansion. Like, just full stop. Like, I like Shivering Isles more than the base game. Like, easily. Buddy, you need to die. Thank you. The door is locked. Oh no. I hear a fucking- I was gonna say, I hear a Skulltula in here. I still have no idea what the fuck that- Oh, is that- Is that... a key? No. There are, however, apparently 9 golden spiders. God, the NPCs in Oblivion look so bad with their, like, potato faces. Now, if I'm gonna stream an Elder Scrolls game, it'll be Skyrim, because that's probably, of all of them, the one I have put the least amount of time into. Like, I played the main quest for my Let's Play, and that is basically all I have played of that game. Like, I didn't hate it or anything, it just, for whatever reason, did not grab me at all. Fuck, fish! Jesus Christ. Yeah, Oblivion... As a game, like, the main quest is kind of ass. Like, I did not enjoy it at all. But there are some, like, really fucking good side quests in that game. Yeah. Yeah, if I'm gonna do, like, a Skyrim stream, it's gonna be modded. Like, I don't even know what I'm going to do, but it will be modded, I can tell you that much. A spider in here? I hear one. It's so weird hearing Zelda sound effects in this game. Like, it just feels wrong. I'm gonna save. Whoa, that's mildly unexpected. No, it's just a wall texture. Huh. Alright, that was a pretty good one. Props to that. Locked. Isle skulls. Fucking heretic golems. Where is the fucker? Oh. Oh, god damn it, of course. Fucking nuke myself. Wrong door. Yeah, like, if you focus on just the main quest in Oblivion, that is actually a surprisingly short game. I think the last time I did a full playthrough of it for just the main quest, it took me, like, 12 hours to play through it. Like, it's crazy. I mean, I guess there's nothing wrong with that, necessarily, because, like, the open world exploration is kind of what I would imagine most people would be there for, but at the same time, like, fuck. Fuck, there's two of them. It's a trap. The fuck was that? Ow. Fucking squid. Yeah, I don't know, it's like, it's one of those things, and like, Bethesda's really good at it, like, where, like, they start you off and everything's like, super, like, high tense, like, tension and everything, and then you're like, go to Whiterun and then nothing happens, until you, like, go see the old fucks on top of the mountain, and it's just like, alright. Like, that's the thing I don't like, we're really good at, fair. Is that, like, yeah, they, I don't know. Like, everything seems really important, and then it's not. And, like, that shit started with Oblivion. Alright. Nice. Sneaky banner. That's basically how I look at them. Like, I don't expect Bethesda's RPGs to be really worth much anymore. Like, I actually lay a lot of blame on that, for that, I should say, on Todd Howard. Holy shit. Thank you, Kuja, I appreciate it. No idea. What we're doing. It just works. I, like, my problem with Todd Howard is that like, he very much is one that wants his games to be like he wants to strip out anything that's complicated in the games, like, and he calls it streamlining them, and it like drives me up the wall because it's not streamlining, it's simplifying, and there's nothing wrong with simplifying your game. The problem is that he's like doing it to such an extreme, you're taking away like the soul of the game. I'm glad to hear that. Like, that means a lot to me that you're enjoying my stuff. I do not accept gifts on Steam, though, so I appreciate it, but I will have to take a pass on that. They did, in fact, remove Levitate and Fly. Well, that's what you have Elder Scrolls Blades at. Yeah, I was gonna say. I mean, they also did Fallout Shelter, which, from my understanding, actually wasn't that bad as far as, like, mobile games go. Oh, goddammit. Nope. These tentacles, I swear, are one of the most dangerous enemies in these underwater areas. Right next to the dang squids. Yeah, the removal of, like, all of the interesting, like, kind of flavory weapons in the Elder Scrolls game kind of killed me a little bit. Like, I miss throwing knives and crossbows, although I think they brought those back in 5? Of course there's zero depth or character development, that's... Can I go into the fucking sphincter? Oh... I was hoping it'd at least kill me or something. Real games have pauldrons. Ah! Like, the armor system... I really liked the minutiae in Morrowind. Don't get me wrong. But, like, from Morrowind to Oblivion, it, like, didn't destroy me. Like, there was still enough there that I was okay with it. But going to Skyrim, though, is kind of painful. Oh, man. Wolson. I have Wolson, and I check it out, like, once every other year, and it never really seems to be making any meaningful progress. Oh, we're dead. I don't like this. I'm dead anyways. I got greedy and tried to move, and the game's like, you die for this. Act 1 release in the balance level. The game's been in beta for like 50 years. Like, Jesus. Like, I bought it, I think, like 3 years ago. Like, my faith in those devs is pretty minimal. I should say my faith in them finishing it is pretty minimal. Well, sure, like, you're more than welcome to make a Let's Play request. There's no guarantee I'll get to it, but yeah, sure. Feel free. Oh, that is stressful. Darkest dungeon, oh my god. Oh, I don't think I have the testicular fortitude to get through a whole playthrough of Darkest Dungeon. I'm not bad at the game. But the game is nasty. Oh shit, sneaky spider. I think I did stream it a little bit. Like, I think I streamed it one Sunday at some point. I know I have done videos of it in some fashion. Yeah, and like, that's the thing, if I were gonna play it, I'd probably play it with mods. Like, it would not be a pure experience. Oh! Trying to hide those delicious Stardust bottles from me. Waifu Dungeon? Oh man, I don't even... Actually, I take that back. I think my wife has put a fair number of hours into Darkest Dungeon. Now that I think about it. She also plays RimWorld. She's been trying to figure out what she wants to, because she wants to start Let's Playing again for like the 50th time. And she can't make up her mind what she wants to play. And she wanted to start one of the Trials of Cold Steel. They're like these JRPGs that are 1,000 hours long. And I told her, no, don't do that. Don't start with like a super long game. Like her starting with Reseteer, I know people liked it, but I think that was probably a mistake. So she wants to do Quest for Glory, because she's really knowledgeable. Oh my god, my aim. She's really knowledgeable about the Quest for Glory games, and she likes them a lot. But I mentioned her playing RimWorld. She really likes RimWorld, so there might be some of that at some point. Man. I fully believe at some point in the future that she is going to return to Reseteer. If I had to guess, she'll probably be starting a new save. But I fully expect she will return to it eventually. I just have no idea when. Because, like, her patience, like, the thing is like, she wants to play these JRPGs, and in her eyes, I'm sure she's hoping that they're going to be like Final Fantasy VI, because she loves Final Fantasy VI, she loves Chrono Trigger, she loves JRPGs from the SNES era, and I think that's what she wants to, like, play more of. And so she's buying these new age JRPGs, and she needs to understand that they're not like Chrono Trigger, they're like dumpster tier anime that you see on Adult Swim. So she's going to go in, and she's going to be so fucking salty. Was that a fucking... That is a reskinned Arc Vile, and I about shat myself there. Oh man, this room is bad. This room is really bad. Don't tell her. I'm not gonna tell her. I'm just telling her not to play, like, not to start with long games. That's the advice that I'm giving her. Like, if she wants to play, that's, you know, more power to her. I'm just telling her that she, like, needs to ease in on, like, something short that she knows really well, because then she'll probably complete it. Darkest Dungeon is a pretty good game. Like, it's brutal as all hell, but, like, I very much enjoy it. I don't know how... I think it would work better as a game that I stream. I don't necessarily think it would work well as a Let's Play because of just, I guess, the nature of it. Like, especially if I did everything on screen, because, like, if you have a high-level party wipe, you've got to, like, grind out replacement characters and stuff. Okay, so rocket launchers, fucking murder skeletons. Good to know. So not Witcher 3? No. No. I've already got people, like, I've had people asking... That skeleton can sit there and rot. He gets nothing. Just like Lysandus. But I've had people asking me when I was gonna start playing Witcher 2 since I completed Witcher 1. Like, literally same fucking day. Whoa, hey there. It's like, come on guys, like... Okay then, good talk. It's like, come on guys, you know. I want some time between, like, the ridiculously long RPGs. Although, from my understanding, Witcher 2 is a much better experience than the first game is. So this is... Aw, man. I don't want to fight whatever the fuck this Metroid-ass-looking boss is. Yeah, like, what I've played of The Witcher 3, I enjoyed. I've played maybe, I don't know, 5 or 6 hours of it, and it was good. So it's something that I want to get to sooner, probably, rather than later. Well, come on, then. You're obviously a monster. Wake up. Maybe it's just the game, like, trolling me. This is totally, like, gonna fucking murder me at some point. I know it. Let's see, we've been in there. Not been in here. Oh. Isaac? Binding of Isaac? Yeah, I don't know about that. I'm actually not particularly good at the Binding of Isaac games. Like, you'd be getting nothing but hours of me bitching. Fucking close quarters skeletons. Not fun. Oh, oh! It was a trick! Illusory floors! The bastards. So where was that? Ah, okay. Oh, this is fucking horror. What is it? Get out my baby here. Oh, this is terrible. This is terrible. Nope, nope, nope. Rocket launcher. Woo. Alright, so now I'm sure that the big, like, dribbly droppy thing is gonna wanna eat my fucking face off. God damn it. Witcher 3 is a long game, from what I understand. And I know once I finish it, people are gonna be like, why are you gonna play the DLCs? And from what I understand, like, the DLCs are long enough to be games in their own right. Which is just like, fuck. So is this stuff... I'm sure that probably opened another one of these. Don't know which one... Rage, Salt, and Petulance. I don't bitch that much. Oh, Witcher 2. Gotcha, gotcha. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Like, from what I understand, not only are they long, but they're also really good. Like, I've heard Blood and Wine in particular is... super, super solid. Okay, did I, like, miss something back here, maybe? Aside from a little health. This is mildly obnoxious. Now there's nothing in here. Sounds like there's a fucking Skulltula trolling around. What the fuck is that shit? How am I even supposed to get that? I can't even jump high enough to get that! Fiends? Unless I gotta like... Ah, there we go. That's kinda cheeky right there. I don't know how I feel about that. Oh man, that level. Man, everybody seems to think that I had a conniption fit at the end. At the end of that, because I did like a cold ending with just no audio. Like. Man. People don't realize that I do half of that shit just for the reactions of you guys in the comments. Like, I was not like hyper mad at the end of that or anything. I swore a little bit, I fully admit to that. There was some cussing, yes, but not like, I'm gonna murder everyone I know type thing. The only thing that inspires that in me is Kingmaker. And even that, like, that's about as ragey as I get. Like, when I'm having a bad time with a game, I'm generally speaking good enough to step away. Except for the Fume Knight in Dark Souls. In Dark Souls 2, I was going nuts with that boss fight. Holy shit. Like, that was some maximum petulance right there. What the fuck, barrel? Oh, whatever. Wonder... where is this asshole? Can I, like... man, it's a shame that these things don't bounce in any, like, predictable fashion. I just, like, bounce them off of the corners and kill that thing up there. It seems, like, way too gimmicky. Ah, there's the electrocution. Oof. Is there anything down here? No. Nope. Nope. Ow! None of that. There we go. Okay, saving. Yeah, Witcher 3 has some beefy system requirements if you want to, like, run it with, like, super, super high settings and stuff. Like, to be fair, though, it doesn't look bad on lower settings. Like, it's just kind of a generally nice-looking game. Blood and Wine has a side quest where Geralt takes mushrooms. Thinks his horse is talking to him. Oh my god. That's pretty great. Fucking cyberpunk requiring a 30-core CPU. Ah, fucking spiders. Just give it time, we're getting there. I want to say I saw a 12-core CPU that somebody was selling. Of course, it's like $3,000, but that's what you pay if you... are you gonna wake up now? No. It's fucking freaking me out. All right, did it open this? Okay, I bet you this is gonna be the one that doesn't. And it opens the snake doors too. Medusa doors unlocked. Saving like a coward. All right, are you? I'm just waiting. Okay. Oh, and now I'm underwater. That's wonderful. How did they do that? Man, I know this is like GZ Doom and like you can do whatever the fuck. And of course I kill it right as I die because I got too close to it. 16 core, 32 thread, third river. Well, there's no problem. It's just why? Like I've got an 8-core in my rig now and like I feel that like that's kind of overkill. The only reason I have it is because I do like video rendering. I mean, if you're doing like CAD and stuff, then yeah, you want like all the power, obviously, but... I need to not get super close so that I don't kill myself with my own rockets again. You need to die, buddy. There we go. Woo! Ouch. Yeah. Like, you generally want to replace your thermal paste, like, I do it like once a year. I'm sure some people probably do it more often than that. Okay, so the Medusa doors are open. Now I just have to remember where they all are. Which I, of course, do not. But yeah, hitting 100 degree, I assume that's Celsius. Like, that's... That's worrying, like, levels of temperature right there. Fuck! Goddamn, these things, like, always... these things have been really well placed. They always get the jump on me. They're... oh, sneaky. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Like, to be fair, I only started replacing mine yearly, like... not this tower, but the tower before it. Like, before that, like, I would install the CPU and then just never touch it again because I feared unseating the things. But they've gotten much more resilient since the days of yore. Oh, what is this? We need a red skull. All right.